Hi everybody, it is Sharon aka Wabaraka and I am back on Real Talks. Before I get started, I would just like to remind you that I do have a YouTube channel. Look out for Sharon Wabaraka Official. You're going to find my music there. Subscribe, like, share and be blessed. But I'm not on music today. I am a woman of many hats that I keep saying. And today it's all about the real thing, real talk. And I'm going to continue. There's a topic I started the other day about the emotional impact on children for being raised in a toxic environment, or the mental health on children who have been raised in toxic environments. And I'd like to continue on that topic. But before I do so, I would like to explain what the human being is so that maybe we start from there and you can have an understanding of what I am trying to talk about and what that means for your children. So to begin with, the human being, or what makes you being called a human being, is made up of three components. That is the body, this body, the spirit, and the soul. Every human being, including children, are spirits. So every human being is a spirit. This body that you see, that you call Sharon, John, Peter, Kamau, Jonah, whatever your name is, this body that you see is only used to house the spirit and the soul. Okay? So inside this body, there is the spirit and there is the soul. Now let us stop there and ask ourselves, what's the soul? The soul is your emotions, okay? And emotions is what causes you to have feelings, anger, fear, pain, whatever feelings that you have, that is within your soul. There is also your emotions, like I said, and there is the will, okay? So in your body, I don't know if you're getting me that, people. So in your body, you've got, in this body, there is the spirit and there is a soul. What is the soul? The soul is your mind, your emotions, and your will. Okay? And that is what is called a human being. That is what is made up of a human body. That's what makes every person be called a human being. Now, when I talk about internal conflict that happens within your body, it is because this body can only house either of the two spirits, either the Holy Spirit or the evil spirit. But those two spirits cannot dwell in the same body at the same time because there's going to be conflict. Okay, are you getting me, people? And that is the same thing for your children. Because children, by nature, are innocent. They naturally carry the good spirit, right? Now, if you're raising children in an environment where it is toxic, you know, they are always watching mommy and daddy fight all the time. That is what we call a toxic environment. And because naturally children carry the good spirit, the environment that they're being raised on is toxic in itself. That means there is conflict, all right? And the conflict does not come from external, it comes from internally, from inside that body. So when I talk about the emotional impact on children, it is not anything that is physical, it is something that happens in the inside of your children, and that is what that conflict that happens inside the body is what is called emotional impact. When children witness parents argue or fight all the time, they become very confused because naturally children love both parents equally. And it becomes so confused for them that they start feeling pain, you know, like when you've got a real wound, a physical wound on your body, on your hand, leg, or whatever part of your body. If you've ever had a wound and it hurts, that is exactly what that happens within the inside, the conflict, the pain is real inside that child. And that is why you're hearing a lot of children saying that they want to harm themselves, or they've got this suicidal ideation because pain is so real for them, and usually they don't know what to do. Remember, children are still developing, their brain is still developing, and so it's not fully developed. That is why the confusion really comes in for these children. So what I do advise parents is, if you do love your children, you need to protect them, and you need to protect them from harm, because that wound, if it's not treated, it goes on and carries on into adulthood. And that is why you're finding a lot of children, or a lot of adults who have been raised up in toxic environment, when they become adults themselves, because the internal injuries were not healed properly, they carry on doing the same thing even to their own children, and then it becomes like a repetition. It's like a cycle that never ends. And so you find the same families are experiencing the same kind of problems. So that is what I wanted to explain about the emotional impact. It starts from inside, from internally. And remember, every human being is a spirit. This body that you see is only the body that is used. God uses this body to carry the spirit that we carry. And this perhaps explains when we die, when every human being dies, it is not the spirit that dies, it's the body and the soul that dies, okay? And maybe while I'm also there, just to explain that the difference between a human being and an animal is that an animal does not have spirit. An animal will only have the body and the soul, okay? But a human being, to be a human being, you have the spirit. That is why when God created man and he said, let us create a man in our own image, it is because God himself is spirit. We all know that God is spirit. So when he said, let us create a man in our own image, it is because he put spirit inside your body to make you look like God. So any other evil spirit that comes to dwell inside your body is not the will of God. The will of God is for your body to house the Holy Spirit. And because the devil was cast out of hell with his demons, he tries to occupy this body, our bodies, because the spirit cannot dwell outside. It cannot dwell in open places. It can only live in a human body, okay? And that is why you find when demons have been cast out, when people go for prayers and deliverance and demons have been cast out, they look for somewhere else. Even the Bible says that when a spirit gets cast out, it wanders looking for a body to enter, because a spirit, whether it is the evil spirit or the Holy Spirit, can only live in a human body. So let us protect our children from the emotional harm. It is a real pain that goes on within our children. That is called, by those who have learned, as mental health. But in simple layman's language, it is a conflict that happens inside of a child that becomes very confusing, that causes this emotional impact. I'm going to stop there for now. I'm going to come back with another topic. Thank you for listening, and thank you for those who have been following me. I love you all. Baraka.